Greetings. The other day, I read an interesting surah. Surah 1047, to be specific. Let's see what it says. Mushin Khan. And for every ummah, or a community or a nation, there is a messenger. To every people was sent a messenger. And for every nation there is a messenger. And for every nation is a messenger. Before we go any further, what is the context of this verse? Surah 10:45. And on the day when he shall gather or resurrect them together, it will be as if they had not stayed but an hour of a day. So from the context, we can see that this Surah 10:47 is claiming to be related to the Day of Judgment. When their messenger comes, the matter will be judged between them with justice, and they will not be wronged. When their messenger comes before them, the matter will be judged between them with justice, and they will not be wronged. And when their messenger cometh on the Day of Judgment, it will be judged between them fairly, and they will not be wronged. So when their messenger comes, it will be judged between them in justice, and they will not be wronged. So the claim in this surah is that on Judgment Day, people of every nation will face the messenger that Allah sent to that nation. The problem this surah causes is this. Surah 1047 claims that a messenger was sent to every nation. Well, let's list and count a few of the prophets and the nation they were sent to. There was Moses. He was a prophet sent to Israel, the Jewish nation. There was Elijah. He was a prophet of the Jewish nation. There was Elisha. He was a prophet of the Jewish nation. There was Isaiah. He was a prophet of the Jewish nation. There was Ezekiel. He was a prophet of the Jewish nation. There was Jeremiah. He was a prophet of the Jewish nation. There was Solomon. He was a king of Israel and a prophet of the Jewish nation. There was David. He was a king of Israel and a prophet of the Jewish nation. There was Yahya, or John. He was a prophet to the Jewish nation. There was Jesus. He was a prophet to the Jewish nation. Are you beginning to see the pattern here? Every single named prophet was sent to Israel. If you call yourself Muslim, help me out here. You must know all the prophets sent to all the other nations, right? There must be thousands, because there have been thousands of nations. Well, maybe hundreds. If you call yourself Muslim, come on, help me out here. Please name 50. Only 50 prophets and the nations they were sent to. You know, a related surah is 35:24. Verily, we have sent you with the truth, a bearer of glad tidings and a warner. And there never was a nation, but a warner had passed among them. Verily, we had sent thee in truth as a bearer of glad tidings and as a warner. And there never was a people without a warner having lived among them in the past. Lo, we have sent thee with the truth, a bearer of glad tidings and a warner. And there is not a nation but a warner hath passed among them. Indeed, we have sent you with the truth as a bringer of good tidings and a warner. And there was no nation, but there had passed within it a warner. So let's look at the phrases again. And there never was a nation, but a warner had passed among them. And there never was a people without a warner having lived among them in the past. And there is not a nation, but a warner hath passed among them. And there was no nation, but that there had passed within it a warner. So 35:24 echoes, or repeats, the claim. Every nation has had a prophet, a messenger, a warner. And if they belie you, those before them also belied. Their messengers came to them with clear signs and with the scriptures and the book giving light. And if they reject thee, so did their predecessors, to whom came their messengers with clear signs, books of dark prophecies, and the book of enlightenment. And if they deny thee, those before them also denied. Their messengers came unto them with clear proofs of Allah's sovereignty, and with the Psalms and the Scripture giving light. And if they deny you, then already have those before them denied. Their messengers came to them with clear proofs and written ordinances, and with the enlightening Scripture. So clearly, every nation had a warner sent, and this warner brought Scriptures and Psalms. And now you can see the problem which Islam cannot answer. According to the Quran, every nation had a messenger sent to it. Every messenger brought their message. Every warner brought their Scriptures. And except for the Judeo-Christian texts, there is not a single scrap of manuscript to support this fantasy. There is not a single prophet a Muslim can name outside the Jewish prophets of the Bible. There should be hundreds. There should be thousands. There should be books, 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 many books, books in every language, books from every nation. The message of the God of Abraham, Allah, should have been in every language from every nation. There is not a single group of believers anywhere in the world or in recorded history outside Judaism and Christianity that follows the God of Abraham, Jehovah. There should be cell groups and pocket groups all over the world, in every nation, in every country. There should be a remnant. There should be archaeology. There should be facts, evidence, history, books, manuscripts, colonies, peoples. There were Jewish groups in every nation after the diaspora. Think about it. Come on, think about it. There is not a single group, single text, single piece of evidence to support this fantasy. The Jews are the Jews. The Christians are the Christians. Try and name one other group or religion that is monotheistic and chants Allah is one alone. Then realize the claim of the Quran is not that only one other warner was sent. The Quran claims every nation should have a scripture and Psalms and a religious group, an ummah, a community founded by that prophet from Allah sent to that nation. If you call yourself Muslim, stop and think about the problem this creates. You cannot find one piece of evidence to support this claim. And if you come up with one reference to one name of, you know, Uzza or Uzziah or some name which has been translated, realize it's still an Israeli prophet. It's a Jewish prophet. There should be millions of examples. Muhammad's point in creating this surah was to try and claim his message was already universally present. That he was just the last in a long sequence to every nation, every tribe, every language, every people. He was the seal of the prophet, the final prophet. Just look around and you will realize this is not the case. This proves the claim in the Quran is false, and the Quran cannot be the word of God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.